So I'm here at the airport actually, and I am getting ready to leave for Indiana this afternoon. So we have a seminar on Sunday. I'm on the pregame show. This is all pre-taped, so I was on the pregame show Saturday night at Hoosier Park. Just horrible weather all week in Ontario. It gave some of the horses a chance to have a week off. You know, Wednesday or Tuesday we train them a little bit, but there'll be nobody training Saturday at the training center. So I looked on the forecast. Next Saturday is supposed to pour rain, so I believe we're going to move the drone to Friday with that. And then we also have our RSVPs keep pouring in. We're up to about 130, 140 people, I think, now RSVP'd for the Mother's Day open house. And as you can imagine, you get 130, 140 people RSVP'd. You know, it's the same as last year. I think on Mother's Day, we only had 120 people RSVP'd, but 300 or 400 people showed up. So it's shaping up like it's going to be a great day. Still have a lot to do for the Mother's Day thing. We have catering. I forgot last year that Racing Under Saddle Russ actually did the barbecue. And I had Aslan and Phil Coleman to do it, who did the Christmas Day thing, the hot dog truck that was there. So actually, I'm a little interested for those of you out there that did attend the Mother's Day and the Christmas Day or Christmas Eve open house. I'm curious which you liked better. Did you like the hot dogs and hamburgers that we were cooking up on the barbecue on Mother's Day? Or did you prefer simply the hot dog truck, the chip wagon, if you will, that was there closer to Christmas time? So I guess the best way to find out is simply ask the people that were there. I was on the track, and we're going to switch gears a little bit this year. Also, I'm going to spend my time up in the broadcast booth, if you will, up in the clubhouse, if you will, for you know, to speak to people and greet them, because geez, there's a lot of people that just went unmet last year in passing, or you know, shake their hand. But I really want to have time to sit down and talk to people about what they're seeing, how the horses look, and what they're doing. We're going to have very, you know, professional people there, drivers there going with the horses, so there's no need for me to be there, I don't think. There's some horses that I'd like to go with, but seeing how they react, seeing how they react to a different driver, so to speak, gives me a different perspective of the horse too, and a fresh set of eyes to look at the horse, say, hey, I think this horse is running in, or this horse does this or is doing that, and that always helps also. So I think Mother's Day is shaping up to be a great, great open house for us. Should be a good time. So on with the show. We have we had a lot of horses race this week. We had some horses leave. Meadowbrook Charlie went to Indiana. We were really struggling to find a class for Meadowbrook Charlie in Ontario. 25 claimer was suitable, but you know, from perspective of an owner, anytime you send a horse on the track and they're 20 to 30 to 1 every week, it's not the right class. And we just couldn't find a proper class for Charlie. He fits a lot of Indiana conditions, so I wish both Rich and Paul Ganji, and of course my man Brian, good luck with Meadowbrook Charlie in Indiana. Also, we're going to be preemptively sending three horses down to Ohio for three very different reasons. Leading up to the stake races this summer, Wind Chaser, we put him on Lasix, he was bleeding a little bit, and I wanted to get him down to Ohio and get him raced down there. So I had made a phone call and spoke with Virgil Morgan, who's one of Ohio and has been one of Ohio's leading trainers for just about ever, I think. And he is going to take Wind Chaser, Redwood Again, and McKinnon down to Ohio and try them out and see how they fare. Again, I think a little complacency in regards to McKinnon and maybe Redwood, and then Wind Chaser, I think just getting down there, getting him settled down before the stakes, probably the smarter thing to do. So those three horses are heading to Ohio this week. Meadowbrook Charlie's leaving today for Indiana, so those four horses will be departing our umbrella, if you will, for hopefully greener pastures down in Ohio and in Indiana. Last night I raced Pay the Line Blue Chip at London outside post. They went in 59, 58, and 4. She paced well. She paced 59-2 and raced reasonably well. In regards to American League, raced well again. Another outside post. Sally was a little bit on the left line, and I know that Jason's working to combat that. He had an old quarter crack left front that was bothering him, and I believe he put pads on him this week. And still on that left line a little bit, might need a little bit of veterinarian work. There's a horse that's raced 6 or 7 times this year, has never been to the vet, has never had any vet work, and I don't think the first time he missed the board was last night, if I'm not mistaken. I know he hasn't missed a check all year, so continued success, hopefully, albeit small, but continued success for American League would be great. Who else we got? Airway raced this week in London, finished 5th, but raced really well. Again, outside post, upper class. They went like 57 over London, which is scorching mile for that class, and raced well. So for Paul, I'm happy he raced well for him. Sally DeVee did not get in this week, sadly, but nevertheless, she'll get in next week. Raced really well her last start in London. I'm wrong. She is in Sunday. I keep forgetting when I look down the list on Trackit, I always just look to see who we have in. But since I'm going away, I didn't look down the list, and I know that Jason had said Sally DeVee is in fact in Sunday night at Flamborough. Now they're supposed to get a pile of rain, and it's supposed to be cold also, so right around freezing. Just about the worst racing conditions you could possibly imagine for the next 48 hours in Ontario. So I don't know if they're going to race or not in Ontario Saturday or Sunday. I hope they do for us, but I could understand if they don't. So Sally DeVee is in fact in tomorrow. Mystical Mission is in tonight in Woodbine. I think we have 2 in at Woodbine, if I'm not mistaken. Mystical Mission is in, and we'll get to the other one in a minute. So Mystical Mission's in. I believe he's in a different condition. I can't really say if he's down or if he's in tough or not. I haven't seen the morning line, but raced better last week. Tried the last half 56-4, last quarter in 28 seconds. You know, when they go in 54 off half and 58, and you're sitting ninth at the half, probably going to finish ninth at the finish. So hopefully we can get him a little bit closer. And again, his footwear probably isn't the best for inclement weather, but his feet bother him. We have razor pads on his front feet. So hopefully he can plow through that track tonight and do some damage, because Daryl's had a real shitty go of it lately. Hoosier Muscle, we shipped out to Julie Walker and Bert Renault, hoping they can get her quieted down. She was a real orangutan sometimes at the track, and I was hoping a fresh set of eyes would help with her. She made a break in the qualifier yesterday, so that hasn't turned out well. Tortola Sunrise made his debut after a month off last night, made a break at the gate, and now we get Mystical Mission tonight. So for Daryl, better days ahead. I mean, I know it's tough. This game's really tough, and Daryl has been with us a long time, off and on over the last decade or more, and just a really, really great owner. So obviously we want to do some good for Daryl, but peaks and valleys, you know. This, you know, we had some real good luck with Mystical Mission in the winter. It's dissipated a little bit, but we're trying to find a class for him where he can really do some damage on a regular basis. And we'll see if we can get that done tonight with Mystical Mission. Touched on American League, raced well. Peregrine Blue Chip, I saw her train the other day, trained well again. She's slowly getting back to the races. Jesus, we've had some bad luck with these Blue Chip horses, you know, and it's not, certainly not Blue Chip's fault, and I would hope it's not our fault, but nevertheless, we haven't had a lot of luck with them, and when you're talking about a world-class farm like Tom Grossman's, that's rare. So we'll do what we can. I'm going to take this call, so I do have to take calls in the morning too, and I'll be back to you in a moment. I'm back, and we were talking about the racehorses. Fan the Flames raced well the other night, finished 6th. Mixed signals with this colt. You know, I'd sent her an email the other day saying, you know, this is a big growthy colt. He races decent every time he goes on the track. He's averaging $1,400 a start his last 5 starts, and we did have a couple of clients that were concerned about Fan the Flames. And, you know, for me, I don't see any issues with Fan the Flames. I've never seen an issue with Fan the Flames in quite a while. I see a colt that's progressing. You know, I would love to see him go out and trot in 57, 58, 59. But at the end of the day, he's making money, he's learning how to be a racehorse, and he's got a big, huge frame on him. So you're going to see you're going to see horses get better and get worse in that time frame. So, you know, for me, Fan the Flames is doing exactly what we need him to do. Yes, he could do more. He could do less too. And I'm very, very happy with Fan the Flames and the way he's going. Zeppelin B is going to be ready to go this week. We trained him the other day in 2 minutes at Mohawk. He's a little bit sick and had an ulcer on his palate. Ulcer on his palate when we went to qualify him, so we had to give him a couple of weeks. Trained better this week and really, really happy with him. Broadway Maya moved from the claiming ranks to the condition ranks and then moved to Mohawk. So it was quite a jump, and she did as well as she could. She trotted in 58. She was just nosed out for fourth, ended up sixth, but raced really, really well. I think we're going to try her back again. I believe she's in to go Monday again, short field. So there's transition from the B track to the A track. So we'll try and get her going also. We claimed a horse last week, Facing Justice. He raced poorly on the weekend, but it looks like he's got a quarter crack or something coming on his foot. So we're going to address that and move forward with him. Buckeye Babe made her first start of the year last night, finished fourth in a short field. I wouldn't say she wowed anybody, but the track was really hard. The rain was coming and they sealed the track. So what they do is they'll screen the track or roll the track at any of the racetracks, and the track gets really hard. She's a tiny filly, she's got tiny feet, and the track really bothered her last night, but she kept her composure somewhat, behaved, didn't make a break, finished fourth, trotted in 2.5 last half and 1.1, which wasn't bad considering the surface last night at Western Fair Raceway. Real Willie raced huge this week, blasted out of the gate, roared to the front, controlled the race. I removed him in the second quarter and got picked off by a $130,000 yearling by and out of Hall of Fame sire and mare of Luke Blaze, that's still heavily staked. Held his own, race well, certainly nothing to be upset about. We'll probably cover him up next week and race him accordingly, but Real Willie's starting to come back real, real strong. Two trips in 55 on less than favorable nights. His first two starts, second and fourth, racing well. Roseron Speedster didn't get in this week. It's been a problem with this colt or this horse the last 10 weeks with sporadic entries where we couldn't get him in. We had to take him to London 1 week, and the 25 claimer was always short a horse, and it seemed like they needed Meadowbrook Charlie to fill that class, and he's not here now. So probably 5 or 6 entered for that class this week, and hopefully we can get other horses into that 25 claimer this week and get him raced. Otherwise we're going to have to look for an alternative class for him. I know Jason has a couple in mind. He texted them to me, and I said, listen, wherever you think he fits best is where he needs to go. So that will happen this week. Boston Glide didn't get in. Sunday, full class at Flamborough. He didn't get in. Monday, short field at Woodbine, short enough that they didn't go with the class. So we're looking at either Thursday at Mohawk or again next weekend at Flamborough. We'll talk to our clients with that, and Jason obviously he said he wanted to think about it, and we talk about it this weekend. So there's that. Road Tripper also didn't get in this week. Geez, an awful trend starting here. Road Tripper didn't get in this week. He'll also be a horse that'll be in next weekend, either Thursday or Friday or Sunday, somewhere next week in Ontario. Paleline Blue Chip, as I said, raced well last night. Stonebridge Hall, only about a week away or so. Kevin said he's training down great and looks great. So we will have him in to go soon enough. Booked the bet, ended up with a heel scratch, and I felt bad. I sent an email out to our clients. They're like, hey, how come Book the Bet's not in? Kevin had sent me a message and said she had a heel scratch. So just like a cut in your finger, but in your heel. And often the heel scratches will get a little tiny bit of surface infection. They're very sore, obviously. You can imagine the amount of flexion in that heel area. And we opted to give her one more week. So I apologize for not being on top of that. Kevin did message me, and I did not convey the message properly. And she will be back in to go, I would say, Thursday at Flamborough, Friday, somewhere in there. She's got the City of London coming up at Western Fair Raceway this week also, so that will be good. Dancing at Midland, come up a little sick in his first start. Still pace 57 his first start. We trained him faster than that, so I'm expecting a big bounce back this week. He missed a week now because of sickness, so he'll be in to go this coming week at Mohawk also. Who else? Master Saver's getting ready. Kevin trained him in 2.8. He's qualifying Thursday. I liked what I saw in the horse. This is his last chance too. I liked what I saw in him training, and I know I like him. He's got a great attitude, but he really has to turn that into some positive racing. And this will be it for Master Saver. If he chooses to squander his last choice, then his last chance here at the stable, then we'll be looking to move him also. But by all accounts, it looks like Kevin's got him under control, and he looked great the other day. Happy holidays, another horse coming back. Really excited about getting this mare back racing. The weather's starting to break, and she really does not like the cold weather. Can't really blame her. She's going to be ready to go in the next week or so, maybe two also. Leroy's Dream, I don't have a touch on Leroy, but he raced great last night. First start, he trotted in 2-3 and looked kind of lackluster. Last night, the poor bugger, he had a mile and a 16th. They went in 2 minutes at the mile marker, and I don't know what the last 16th was, in 8 or 9 seconds. And so Leroy probably trotted his mile in 2-1 and went another 16th. Ended up 6th, but was in 4 lengths, maybe 5 lengths of the lead. Finishing up, raced well. Now the big three, Canale Hanover, Lawmaker, and Cruising in Style. All three of these horses trained well this week. All three have been around 57. We'll be schooling or qualifying them all on Thursday. And they will begin their three-year-old campaign very soon. I believe Cruising in Style will either qualify a race here and then head to Andrew Harris and Vernon Downs, where he has the Empire Stakes and the Breeders' Cup, or he will be racing, or he'll be sent right down to Andrew before we race him here and get a tightener down there. I guess that'll be up to Andrew and our group and myself in exactly what we're going to do with Cruising. So we'll see what happens with him. Same with Lawmaker. Stakes start May. Be nice to get one start into him here in Ontario. But again, we'll see what happens there. And the same with Canale Hanover. Same trajectory, hopefully, with all three of these colts. All three looked good last week when we went with them. So very, very happy with those three. Very, very happy with the horses. We touched on Mother's Day. Touched on RSVPing. Don't forget to RSVP the Mother's Day open house. Anyway, we will be talking in a moment about all the babies, how they trained this week, our movers of the week, top 10 of the week, and how everybody is looking heading into, it's hard to believe, but it's 90 days, inside 90 days of making their first starts, inside 60 or 70 days of making their first qualifiers. So really exciting times for us. Horses are starting to really look good. Very, very happy with how the last drone session went. Today was supposed to be our next drone session, but it was a bit of a washout, if you will. And we will be looking to have our next drone session next Friday. So lots of good things going on, lots of movement in the stable, if you will. And we'll be talking with the babies in just a moment. Just about to board my flight, and it dawned on me that I forgot about Art Seeker. How the hell did that happen? Probably raced better than any other horse this week. Maybe not Willie, but raced very, very good this week. Finished second in 57 at Flamborough, but if you watch the race, snapped out of the gate, let the favorite go, followed him. I had a little trouble getting him into the passing lane because he gets on the left line a little bit in the straightaways. But had I been able to come to the outside, I think I would have made it at least closer. I don't want to say that I would have beat that horse. I think I might have, but I definitely would have given him more of a scare. So really, really impressed with Art Seeker and the way he raced on Friday night. I think it was Friday night. Thursday night. Thursday night. So we're literally sitting on the tarmac getting ready to taxi out. I'm done of the racehorses now. That's it. I swear. And next stop will be Indiana for the show tonight, which I guess when you're watching this was 2 days ago. So very, very happy with Art Seeker, and mediocre, I would say, an okay week racing, but all our big guns are getting ready to fire up here soon. Babies are 60 days away from their qualifiers, 90 days away from their first stake race. So it's getting to be a really exciting time here at the stable. And next, we will be on to our movers of the week.